Welcome to part two of this ocean resin tutorial on how to make resin ocean art using real sand and plaster. My name's Michelle Tracy, and if you haven't done so already, please go check out part one of this video. Today there's no need for my mask because I'm using art resin. It's non-toxic, there's no solvents and no fumes. Perfect. After mixing for 5 minutes, you can let the resin sit in the cup for a further 5 minutes just to allow those tiny bubbles to rise to the surface and start to dissipate. I actually don't need to because after I mix all these pigments, I then let these individual cups sit for 15 minutes to thicken, so that way all the bubbles rise anyway. The colours from Just Resin I've used are Titanium White, Breakfast at Tiffany's and Turquoise Luster, exactly the same as on the previous layer. So the first layer has dried hard, I left it overnight and I did give it a light sand, but only on the area I plan to pour this layer on. Again, I'm tilting the board in the direction of the flow of water and I made sure I didn't cover up the entire wet sand area because I want some of that to still the previous layer to show through. I did wait about 10 minutes before pouring the white because I wanted it to thicken up and be more opaque and sit on the surface of that layer. And I'm just pouring quite a thin line just because it's a more of an overhead aerial shot. And as always, these close-up angles are more true to life in terms of colour. Look at that beautiful colour. Compared to that, I mean, I could just keep playing around with it for ages, but you just gotta know when to stop, and plus the resin will start setting, so it's best to just quit while you're ahead. So I'll let this first wave now dry overnight to harden before I apply the final and third wave, or second wave I should say, second wave, third layer. For the final layer, I'm just going to use clear resin because I'm happy with the colors underneath and I just don't feel like it needs any more colour. So yummy at this angle, oh my god. I used a blowtorch to pop the bubbles and then I let it sit for 10 minutes before applying the white. This will show the white was thicker again like the first layer. For thin waves like this, I have my heat gun set to a low speed. It's probably still on like a medium heat, but a low speed so it's not getting blowing it out of control. There's not a lot of pigment on there, so I don't want to completely blow it off. Totally multitasking here. I don't always get the opportunity to shoot vertical shots for real, so I thought I'm taking this glove off, I'm doing it. And the painting is now complete. I really hope you like how it turned out. Everything seemed to go to plan with this one. It was pretty good. And as always, leave your comments for me. I love reading them. And if you have any questions about this process or anything else, please let me know. My name's Michelle Tracy, and thank you so much for watching.